while most chased profits. One early Bitcoin user saw a different kind of potential and helped invent what would become one of crypto's most famous uses.
I'm an artist and have been an artist for a long, long time, but I wasn't always. I studied philosophy and literature, and that was my main kind of interest.
In the early 2000s, Kevin and Jennifer McCoy were successful digital artists. Their works shone by prestigious galleries. But unauthorized copies were appearing all over the internet. They realized there was no such thing as a digital original that they could actually own and control.
In a digital environment, of course, it's always a copy, and it proliferates, everywhere. And so there is no original.
But Bitcoin gave Kevin an idea.
And that system created for the first time an idea of digital scarcity. All of a sudden, the everyday norm that you had about digital technology, that it's infinitely reproducible, that it's everything is just copy and paste, that didn't apply in this case. If I send you my Bitcoins, I don't have them anymore, and you have them. That's scarcity. It's not everywhere. It's only somewhere. And so I had this realization that if it was possible via Bitcoin to create uniqueness around currency, then there had to be a way that you could create uniqueness around a digital artwork. But I didn't know how.
I'm really excited about this last pairing.
Kevin attended a conference where each artist was paired with a tech partner and given 24 hours to develop a new idea they'd present to an audience.
What we want to talk to you about today is this idea we have of monetized graphics and how we can put digital artworks in chains.
So almost immediately after I was paired up with Kevin McCoy, he and I sat down and started sketching out ideas for how could you make an assertion on a blockchain to say that a certain digital work was an original, unique item.
After an all-night coding session, Anil Dash and Kevin announced that they had registered a video on a blockchain.
It was a segment of a video work that Kevin and Jennifer McCoy had created together, and I actually found it mesmerizing.
And this was our on-stage example of taking this file and creating a blockchain-based record of that.
We've created a system that will establish verification and provenance over digital files, digital artworks. That provenance is a chain of ownership.
Anil and Kevin created a record of ownership that would live on the blockchain. Whoever held the key to access it owned the digital original.
We did pull it together in a couple hours. So given that it was something we sort of did over the course of an evening and into a late night, it was a pretty good first version.
You got $20?
And we sort of said we'd negotiate a price for it.
Can I pay you in U.S. dollars?
Sure.
All right.
It's cool with me.
I have $4.
Jesus. Really?
It was the first transaction of something that would eventually come to be called a non-fungible token, or NFT.